Let us begin with today the example of fixed capital method. That day we have done question number A, that is as per the floating capital account. In today's class account class 4, begin with question number 9. In your textbook you will find this question on page number 32. See, the question says that Bhadresh and Viral are the partners of a firm. Their profit and loss sharing ratio is 3:2. You need this information where you have to distribute the profit. On 1/4/16, the total capital of partner is 420,000. So when the total capital is given, we have to distribute this capital among the ratio, that is what the proportion of their fixed capital is 4:3. So 420,000 will be distributed among 4:3. You will get the figure 240,000 of the first partner and 180,000 of the second partner. So follow the instruction. When the total capital is given, whatever ratio is mentioned, that will be followed. So here the ratio is 4:3. So you can mention over here that total capital 20,000 distributed among 4:3. On this day, the balance of the current account. Now we are following the fixed capital method. It means you have to prepare two accounts. One is the fixed which remain fixed. There won't be any entry in the fixed capital account. So your fixed capital balance also be the same on 31st March 17 and your balance remain the same. So in this manner, fixed capital work is over. Now the current capital account. As per the guidance the given, the balance of the current capital account as follows. Bhadresh is having credit balance. On the credit side, by balance brought down, in the column of Bhadresh, you have to write 36,000. While the Hiral, that he is having the balance of 24,000 debit. When the debit balance is mentioned, it means that the partner has withdrawn more money than the available balance. So this balance is as good as drawings. As per the partnership fee, 12% interest is payable on capital of the partner. So which capital? That fixed capital. 240,000 and 180,000 of that. The interest on capital which become an expense of the firm and become income for the partner. The interest at 12% should be calculated. Formula you know. Interest is equal to PRN upon 100. So with that formula, you will get the figure 28,800, 21,600. Outer column, the figure becomes 50,400. Whatever you write on the debit side of P&L appropriation account, that becomes income for the partner. So that will come on the credit side of partner's current capital account. So two interest on fixed capital, 28,800, 21,600. Then provide 10% interest on opening balance of current account. Now the partner having credit, current account open balance, 10% of it means 3600 become income for the partner and become expense for the firm. So interest on current capital 3600, outer column only partner B. Like that, the partner B current capital account balance is debit, Hiral balance is debit. So 10% of that 24,000 become 2400. So here interest on current capital of Hiral 2400 which become income for partner and expense for the firm. So interest letter in the column of year 2400 to be mentioned. Then interest on drawing to be charged at 12%. Now the drawings, you have the given balance of drawings that the Bhadresh has withdrawn 36,000 on 1/10, 36,000, and the another partner has withdrawn Hiral on 1/17, 4800. Of these two, you have to charge interest at 12%. So 12% here you have to find for the 6 months, because 1/10. 10 means your 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 6 month interest. And here 1/1. So January, February, March, 3 month interest. So 6 month, 3 month, 12%, PRN upon 100. The formula applied. You will get interest on drawing 2160-1440. This become income for the firm, become expense for the partner. So it will come on debit side of current capital account. So that effect is given. Then you have that 2400 per month salary to be paid to the Bhadresh for active role. So 2400 salary per month. So 2400 into 12, that Bhadresh entitled to receive 28,800 as a salary. Expense for the firm will come here by salary in the column of Bhadresh as an income for the partner. Then you have that 10% commission on the net profit is payable. Now, where it is mentioned on the net profit, it means that before doing this adjustment, you have to find the divisible profit. So total of this 412,800 minus this three figure, the figure which are available to you, interest on fixed capital, interest on current capital and salary. If you subtract, you will get the difference 3,30,000 of that 10%. Okay, this is after charging such commission. So the equation will be that 100 plus 10 commissions, the 110. So with that, if you calculate, your commission will come 30,000. This commission to be given to Hiral. So income for the Hiral by commission 30,000 in her column. Okay, then you have to distribute the profit among the partners as per the 3:2 ratio. So now again, total is already done earlier, same total to be written here. Now subtract the four figures, that is your interest on fixed capital or current capital, the salary and the commission. You will get the difference, that is 3 lakh rupees. This difference to be distributed among the partner as 3:2 I hope that all